రాజ్యసభల ధాన్యం కొనుగోళ్లపై కేకే పీయూష్ గోయల్ మధ్య వాదోపవాదనలు జరిగాయి ప్రతి గింజా కొంటామని కేంద్రం చెప్పిందని యాసంగిలో వచ్చేది బాయిల్ రైస్ మాత్రమేనని టిఆర్ఎస్ ఎంపీ కేకే అన్నారు బాయిల్డ్ రైస్ ఎంత కొంటారో కేంద్రం స్పష్టత ఇవ్వాల్సిందేనని పట్టుబట్టారు గత ఏడాది 94 లక్షల మెట్రిక్ టన్నుల ధాన్యం కొన్నారని ఈ ఏడాది ఇప్పటివరకు 19 లక్షల మెట్రిక్ టన్నులు మాత్రమే కొన్నారని అన్నారు ఇంకా ఎంత కొంటారో కేంద్రం చెప్పాలని కేకే డిమాండ్ చేశారు బాయిల్డ్ రైస్ ఇవ్వమని గతంలో తెలంగాణ లేఖ ఇచ్చిందని కేంద్ర మంత్రి పీయూష్ గోయల్ అన్నారు ప్రతి ఏటా వరి ధాన్యం కొనుగోలు పెంచుతున్నామని తెలంగాణ నుంచి ధాన్యం సేకరణను పెంచామని చెప్పారు ఖరీఫ్ కొనుగోలు పూర్తయ్యాక యాసంగి గురించి ఆలోచిద్దామని అన్నారు పీయూష్
సెంట్రల్ గవర్నమెంట్ ప్లాన్స్ టు ప్రొక్యూర్ ఎంటైర్ రైస్ ఇర్రెస్పెక్టివ్ టైప్ ఫ్రమ్ ద స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ అండ్ ఐ హావ్ ఆల్రెడీ గాట్ ది ఆన్సర్ ఫ్రమ్ ఏ యూనియన్ క్యాబినెట్ మినిస్టర్ హూ సేస్ ఐ యాజ్ ఎ యూనియన్ క్యాబినెట్ మినిస్టర్ ఆఫ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ సెంటర్ సే దట్ ఎవ్రీ పీస్ ఆఫ్ గ్రెయిన్ will be procured by the central government this is a stand of central does the government stand by this statement that whatever we produce this is a fact that cmr left which you are saying that is called marketable surplus whenever we are selling we use it for our consumption and we use it for welfare programs that is milled price what is left is that we are talking about let us not confuse a thing we are only talking of what is left with us last year you took 94 lakh tons this year you have taken 19 lakh tons perhaps you would take like will you at least take that 94 lakhs which you have taken last
in the kharif season they had estimated that they will give us 50 lakh tons what they were finally able to give was only 32.66 lakh tons then in the rabi season they had estimated 55 lakh tons so finally they are saying that they have procured rice they have procured paddy to make 61.87 lakh tons we have on our part agreed that we will procure the rice which they and the material that they provide us up to 94.53 lakh tons which they are claiming that they have procured but even today as we speak 29 lakh tons is pending they have not yet been able to give the agreed quantity so there all the time I don't know why this political issue has been raised in the state of Telangana they still have to give us 29 lakh tons when we asked them for physical verification and our teams went for physical verification a number of discrepancies were found in the stock in fact the stock was not even maintained in a proper fashion despite that and month after month we have been giving extensions we have been supporting the state government in every possible way despite all that I don't see the reason to once again and again and again politicize a simple thing where we are saying that there is an MOU based on that MOU we are buying paddy we are buying rice from all over the country in a certain fashion there is a regular process that's going on for years the honorable agriculture minister has already announced on the floor of the house that MSP operations will go on as they are going on now but again and again if they want us to make specific fresh statement in different formats I don't see any reason for that sir
minister has casted certain aspersions he spoke about the discrepancies between the state and the center
Please put your question.
No, my question has to be clarified, yes. sir, because yes. when it comes from the Honorable yes. Minister, it has to be the record has to be set straight.
Yes.
There has been a doubt on Government of India regarding the quantum of rice grown in Telangana, for which officials from Government of India went to Telangana, verified what is the quota we gave, what is our projection we gave, what is the area sown. That has been verified, and it was concluded that it is almost 99.99%. It is the same, so there is no discrepancies there.
Please,
that record I wanted to set it straight, sir.
Please.
Second, how did it grow so much in the last 4-5 years? There has been a tremendous investment in the irrigation sector, which resulted in more area coming under irrigation and more area coming under paddy, sir. Now, the third point, which we have been agitating for a while. while the honorable minister's statement here is contrary to the honorable minister, central minister's statement in Telangana. Honorable minister says we will not buy para boiled rice because we have sufficient stock. The minister in Telangana says that we will buy every grain of rice. So through you, what I would like to clarify now, sir, the minister through FCI, they have a record of the buffer stock. They have a record of the para boiled rice. So if you feel that you have sufficient para boiled, no, let me conclude, sir. We've been agitating. If you have the record, they have the record, sir. They have the record. If you have enough para boiled rice to feed the country for 2 years, tell us not to grow para boiled rice. The reason why we are agitating now for, no, kindly, so 30 seconds. The reason why we are agitating today is ki aaj jo hai so woh fasal ka kaam shuru ho gaya. People have started sowing seeds for sowing crop for Rabi. If the minister says I will let you know in March,
please,
what will we do with it?
No,
that
please,
is our humble submission. Kindly bear
please,
with me, sir.
Please.
Let the honorable minister be very specific. Will he procure in Rabi or not? Because the procurement in Rabi would be only paraboiled from Odisha and Telangana.
Mr.
Minister has casted certain aspersions. He spoke about the discrepancies between the state and the center.
Please put your question.
No, my question has to be clarified,
yes,
sir, because when it comes from the honorable minister, it has to be, the record has to be set straight.
Yes.
There has been a doubt on Government of India regarding the quantum of rice grown in Telangana, for which officials from Government of India went to Telangana, verified what is the quota we gave, what is our projection we gave, what is the area sown. That has been verified, and it was concluded that it is almost 99.99%. It is the same. So there is no discrepancies there.
Please,
that record, I wanted to set it straight, sir.
Please.
Second, how did it grow so much? In the last 4 or 5 years, there has been a tremendous investment in the irrigation sector, which...
In the Kharif season, they had estimated that they will give us 50 lakh tons. What they were finally able to give was only 32.66 lakh tons. Then in the Rabi season, they had estimated 55 lakh tons. So finally, they are saying that they have procured rice, they have procured paddy to make 61.87 lakh tons. We have, on our part, agreed that we will procure the rice which they, and the material that they provide us up to 94.53 lakh tons, which they are claiming that they have procured. But even today, as we speak, 29 lakh tons is pending. They have not yet been able to give the agreed quantity. So they are all the time, I don't know why this political issue has been raised in the state of Telangana. They still have to give us 29 lakh tons. When we asked them for physical verification, and our teams went for physical verification, a number of discrepancies were found in the stock. In fact, the stock was not even maintained in a proper fashion. Despite that, and month after month, we have been giving extensions, we have been supporting the state government in every possible way. Despite all that, I don't see the reason to once again and again politicize a simple thing where we are saying that there is an MOU. Based on that MOU, we are buying paddy, we are buying rice from all over the country in a certain fashion. There is a regular process that's going on for years. The Honorable Agriculture Minister has already announced on the floor of the House that MSP operations will go on as they are going on now. But again and again, if they want us to make specific fresh statement in different formats, I don't see any reason for that, sir.